in a family where my mother was tough. She used to see me get pushed around. And she said to me, son, you may not start a fight, but you better finish a fight. We're here because we didn't start this fight. We didn't disrespect anybody. We do our work and we do it well. We work together. We have the principle of collective work with dignity. We didn't start this fight. We didn't try to cut edges. We're not the ones who fought against the responsibilities that we willfully and willingly took as laborers. We didn't start the fight, but we are we're going to finish this fight. Are you with me? Another thing my mother said to me, and she was tough. She said, you break it, you buy it. So whenever I broke something, I never took credit for it because I didn't have the money. But when it comes to this global economic crisis that we're facing, when it comes to the fact that the country is broke, that millions and millions of people are being laid off, and not one Wall Street banker, not one representative of any of the major financial houses has seen one day in jail. We get notices and they get bonuses. We get foreclosed on and they get 401ks. They get their benefits kicked up and we get kicked out. We didn't break the system, so why should we have to pay for it? And I stand with you in solidarity today, and I declare to you, and we're not going to stand for anybody trying to balance the budget on our backs. Taking our pensions, our pay. We are not going to stand for it, but we're going to stand together. And so, as a member of the faith community, I want to make a prediction today. It's a prediction based on our past. Of collective work, of fighting, of standing together. This is the prediction that we will win. Why are we gonna win? Because when we fight,
we win.
Oh, you don't hear me. When we fight,
we win.
When we fight,
we win.
When we fight,
we win.
Give yourselves a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Ozomatli coming to the mic.